my friend and friends. You are gazing upon the sacred, our sacred drawer of junk, or what is known to the common folk, the junk drawer. This is what ours looks like. I am sure your sacred drawer of assorted accoutrements looks much different. You do have a junk drawer, right? Okay, just checking. But as I was saying, this is ours. So let us spend the next few minutes, several minutes, 15, 20, 25, 28, 32 minutes, however long this video will be, exploring what lies within the junk drawer. I'll allow you a moment to feel the power, the presence of the junk drawer. Do you feel its powers? Let the relaxing power of the junk drawer waft over you. Now, let us see what untold mysteries await for you, my friend. Wherever shall we start? Perhaps right here. This propylene-based plastic container holds individual power cells capable of bestowing the power and enabling all manners of technological marvels. Do you see? This is just one of the many marvels of the junk drawer. Here, you see, what is known as a flashlight, ever ready for emergency use. So ever ready now, but if I were to install a new pair of fresh batteries. Well, I should leave those out. I will install batteries after this video is over, but I just wanted to show you. Just one of the many magnificent marvels . Leave that aside. What else do we have? A clipping clip device used for keeping your favorite snack bag closed. We also have this beautiful tibia bone. Every junk drawer should have one. I'm sure you have a bone, a human bone of some sort, in your junk drawer. A Phillips head screwdriver. Very important for, well, screwing in screws, obviously. What else lies within Yes, duct tape, so very important, so very useful for so many things. I'm sure your junk drawer has duct tape or electrical tape. If you are a member of the International League of junk drawer enthusiasts, then you definitely have at least one roll of duct tape. What else do we have? Chalk markers of an assorted variety of colors, yellow, purple, pink, blue, green, orange, and red. No junk drawer should be without them. Yes, of course. the sacred. Large bag clip. Can you see that, my friend? For when you have large bags, such as a family size bag of barbecue potato chips or sour cream and onion or popcorn, whatever your favorite snack might be, what else do we have? Let us see. Ah, yes. Scotch tape. The scotches were always good for something, and it is magic tape, as you can see. Far more powerful than simple, ordinary, everyday, off-brand, transparent tape. No junk drawer should be without it. And of course, an empty package of pens, four color pens. This, most people would throw this out and discard it like trash. But we, you and I, and we know better, don't we? Sacred package must be kept in the junk drawer until an appropriate time has come where it will be discarded, but not before then. What else? What other mysteries lie within the junk drawer? Over here in the corner, we have sticky notes and assorted index cards of a very vivid, bright colors, purple or pink and green. Very important to have in a junk drawer, because you never know when you might need to write down a list of things, an address, a recipe. Very important. And of course, post-it notes. Just as equally important, if not more so, than the index cards, for with a post-it note, you can write down the name of your favorite physician and their phone number. As you can see there, I hope it's a little bright in here. There. Many useful purposes for post-it notes. Oh, I almost forgot. The glue, the Elmer's glue, whether it's the white or, in this case, the washable clear glue. So very important for every junk drawer. You never know when you might need to glue something. I don't think there is anything else in here. Well, we only have so much time today. Perhaps next time we'll explore what lies within this box in the corner of the junk drawer. You can see how organized our junk drawer is. If you need a pen, you go into the box. If you need an empty package that used to hold pens, you go into the box. Do you need tape? You go into the box. Glue. Do you need electrical tape? You go into the box. But if you need anything else, you go over to the various other sections. For instance, in this corner, a scanner radio, always very important. Listening to the local authorities to make sure none are driving by your house or looking for someone that fits your description. That always stays in the bottom left corner. Let us explore the top left section. Here we find very important user manuals, as well as multi-use labels. Very important. as you can see, assorted manuals for highly advanced technological accoutrements, more index cards. It is always good to have index cards in the main section as well as the manual section. Envelopes, while these may not be manuals, it is good to keep the envelopes in the manual section because you may never know when you might need an envelope to mail a letter. More manuals, protection plan. This is needed for every junk drawer. Should anything happen to your junk drawer, you know it will be protected. Again, more assorted manuals, more manuals, Crockpot, Communist Manifesto, Microwave Manual, and a steamer manual written in Spanish, I believe. And of course, a small USB cord hidden in a corner of the manual box, and more post-its as well, and a battery. The placement of the USB cord, the single battery, and the post-its in the bottom of the manual box provides protection for the manuals. I will put the other manuals back in their spot after the video. And that, my friends, is the junk drawer packing tape. There it is. I was wondering what happened to my game of Touch Me. I love to play Touch Me. Perhaps one day, my friend, you and I can play Touch Me together. That would be a dream of mine, to play Touch Me with you. You could play Touch Me. I could play Touch Me. Just imagine how much fun. I do need a battery for it. Right now, I cannot play Touch Me. So very sad. More tape, glue stick, and that, my friend and friends, is our sacred junk drawer. Drawer of junk, of assorted accoutrements that are necessary for many occasions. I hope that you enjoyed getting to witness firsthand our junk drawer, but perhaps also feel inspired to organize it. Do you see how masterly organized the junk drawer is? Whenever I need a manual, I go over here. An envelope, I go over here. Do I need a decapitated rubber chicken head? I go over here. Do I need, where's my tibia? Oh, it's right here. You see? What was the number for Corvus's and what room number? Oh, it's right here on this sticky. What, I need the glue gun. Where's my glue gun? Oh, it's right here. Beneath the index cards. So you see everything. I need a pencil. Well, it's right here. Next to the box that also holds pencils. You see how very simple? Everything. Where is the measurer for measuring sizes of clothing? To measure your shoulders, to measure your waist, see how skinny or fat you are, how malnourished or overweight you are, you see? It's right here, next to the Phillips screwdriver and the tibia. So everything is perfectly arranged in such a manner so that we always know where it is. More screwdrivers. Stapler. You see? And so that will conclude this video. Again, I hope you enjoyed. Hope you feel inspired. And I hope you feel the power of the junk drawer. And that will conclude this video. Take care, my friend and friends, and I hope to hear about your junk drawer and its many mysteries. Until next time, take care, stay well, be safe, and have fun with your junk drawer.